Hey guys, Mick Reeps here, and welcome back to another episode of The Witcher. You join me and Geralt in the tavern of New Narracourt. In the last episode, we kind of got told to propose to Shani by Shani, which was the weirdest thing in the world, because that was out of the blue, a little bit unexpected, and we found out that Shani's got a bit of a green-eyed monster in her when it comes to Triss. She hates her. Well, we don't have time to be torn between two lovers. We got a little possessed boy that we got to figure out. That seems so wrong. But, yeah, we went to Triss's house to say, look, kind of palmed the boy off with Shani because she's going to be a better mum than you, which really won't go down very well at all.
Indeed.
I'm not looking forward to that conversation. But you know what? We can't even find Triss anymore. We do have a quest that says a posh reception. Triss is trying to convince me to go to Livardin's reception. It's due to take place on the upper floor of New Narracourt. So let's go see if we can do that. Can I come in? 6 in the evening? Well, can you make it 6 in the evening, please? Jesus. Let's rest till 6 o'clock.
Any rooms?
5 orange.
Thank you very much. This isn't exactly a room. This is just a mat by the fire. Wait, did they say 6 p.m.? 12. It's got to be there, right? Get my meditate on. Come back. Try to get upstairs. Hello? Oh, I thought I went into a coma. It's a drunken sleep. Oh, just straight up. Guard's gone. Oh, there we are. She's going to be annoyed. Wish me luck. Wish me luck, guys.
Here we are. Wipe that frown off your face, you'll be fine.
Can't we go back to your place? Make sure I have no internal injuries.
Later, Geralt. Come on, this isn't so bad. Let's mingle.
Mm-hmm.
Who are we mingling with? Look around, maybe meet someone interesting.
Smile, Witcher. This won't take long.
I knew a Witcher.
You're not interesting.
Why did they all come if they dislike Luvarden? Why did they all come if they dislike Luvarden?
Old Vizima's ashes still smolder, and the royal family consorts with the Nilfgaardian.
Oh. Cheese is most exquisite, with a red SS.
No.
Old Vizima's ashes still smolder, and the royal family consorts with the Nilfgaardian.
My legs just start dancing.
They do indeed.
I love this tune.
Good lad.
Dislike Luvarden.
Don't disturb. Don't disturb.
Alright, jeez. Can always go through that way. Oh, there's old Livardin.
Welcome to Lord Livardin's feast.
Thank you. It's a pleasure. Count DeWitt. Oh, these are all special people. Velrad. Why do I know Velrad? Thaler's here. Let's have a chat with Thaler. What's going on?
Geralt, have you met Thaler?
Thaler? Here?
It's not Thaler, it's Thaler.
Let me introduce my master, the Honorable Erkin von Blunt.
Good day, sir.
Erkin has taken a vow of silence and thus cannot answer. You must be wondering why he is here.
Indeed.
He has made numerous vows in his life, one of which is to protect the royal family. Sadly, for unknown reasons, Princess Ada holds little respect for him. Vows, however, must be honored, whatever the circumstances.
And how are you involved? Are you bound by his vows by extension?
He authorized me to speak on his behalf, and I serve as his advisor.
Of course. We shan't be bothering you. Come, Geralt.
Let's have a look at the new entry. What's going on? He's an interpreter. There was circumstantial evidence suggesting that Talar was working for the Salamander, yet he proved to be innocent. To my surprise, Talar the Fence was invited to Lavardin's reception, at which only the rich and influential were present. Well, he's a fucking CIA head man. Of course he's going to be there. Did you forget that? Did you forget that, Carol? Velrad. Why do I know that name? Something tells me I should know Velrad. Let's have a look. Whoa. What's going on with Kalkstein? For the first time since I arrived at Kaer Morhen, I saw a truly happy man. The door to the tower in the swamp stood wide open, and the thought of all that alchemical secrets wasting inside Kalkstein was a delorious... It was as delirious as a drunken dwarf. Val. No, I've never met this guy. Okay. We'll meet you now. Have a chat with you. Riveting. Cool. Let's see if he has a drink. He's wasted. He is so drunk. Okay. We've just sold all our drink, but... would you like a wine? It doesn't look like a wine type of guy to me. But all we've got is white wine, red wine. Nilfgaardian lemon. No, you're not having that. It's a potion base. Here, have some wine. Let's go for it. Merry Christmas. Can we get him to forget his vows? Oh, that would be cool. How much of this junk would we need to get him to? Oh, you're going for it? You're going to get wasted, buddy. We good? Almost? Please tell me. Yes!
I'm drunk. He speaks. I broke my vow. I swore on a heron.
A heron?
Nonsense. Tala hired me to come incognito to the feast.
You blew it.
No scene, please. This ring will get you in the house of the night. Half price.
Very nice. Right, but now I am wasted, and I'm pointing at random people. Hey, Triss. Check my new ring out.
Smile, Witcher. This won't take long.
Oh, Triss, I am so drunk. How do I get undrunk? Well, maybe I should have thought about this. I thought I could just go to the fire, rest up. Now I'm wasted. Right. We're going to speak to Thaler again because his boy's gone. Mate as well. Then we've got obviously these important people. Declan himself. Oh, we're walking a bit faster. We'll walk faster sideways. Maybe we're a crab.
We'll speak shortly.
Yes, we will.
Geralt, allow me to introduce Burgomeister Velarad.
Charmed.
Velarad.
Greetings. It's been a while.
Velarad is King Foltest's right hand.
No need for formal introductions. If you wish to open a factory or a shop, kill a monster, or petition the king, you must come to me.
I'll remember that.
Excuse us, Burgomeister, but we need to say hello to the other guests.
I've really got to come to you to kill monsters? I'll be in your office more than you. Velarad governs Vizima, the capital of Temaria. Or Temera. Mary. In Fulton's absence, Velarad is the highest authority in the city. The Burgomeister knows me from long ago, since he was the one whom I negotiated the contract for lifting Princess Ada's Striga curse. Oh, Ada's the girl from the start, yeah. Well, I don't remember Velarad. I have a vague feeling that he's grown old and taken to drink since we first met. People say that Velarad has lost his authority and doesn't run the city as efficiently as he used to. Okay. I'm really, really bunged up and stuffy today, so I do apologize if that's coming over. Or if I start sneezing. I've got taxi. Oh, ho, ho. Female companion?
Would you be so kind and fetch me some pâté? Would you be so kind and fetch me some pâté?
I've got some pâté right here for you. Let's play pâté cake.
Would you be so kind and fetch
Get your own pâté, you lazy wench. Okay.
Buy low, sell high. Rejoice in the profits and make the books.
Count de Wet.
Get out of my sight, freak.
That's not very nice, is it? Oh wait, see the aura of the flaming rose. Do you not know me? Ada, how are we doing?
Milady, allow me to present the sorceress Triss Merigold and...
De Wet, I know who stands before me. We know each other, do we not, Witcher?
One could say so, Princess.
A princess indeed, though I do not always feel like one. So many duties.
Jeez, lovely.
Imagine,
all three of her.
Why do you stare? Is my dress displeasing?
Nope, it's very pleasing. Oh. Alright, should we go there? Do you want to go there? I don't think we should go there. Oh, should we talk about the elephant in the room? Nah, let's just
Forgive
try and wear
me, lady,
drunken.
But even the finest dress would pale in comparison to you.
Mind your tongue, mutant.
Hey.
Duet, I will decide if and when I am offended.
Your Highness, he is an aberration.
Silence. It was a nicety. Leave us for now.
Yeah. The hell out of here. Roderick Duet. So Ada, at Lavardin's reception, I had the chance to meet Princess Ada. Some years ago, I relieved her of her Striga crust, and the princess has grown into a pretty, if some wild and spoiled girl. And where are you? Roderick. I met Count Duet at Lavardin's reception. He hails from Nilfgaard, belonged to the Order of the Flaming Rose, and advises Kingfall Test on behalf of the Order. He's exceptionally loathsome and arrogant, and he came to hate me for the moment we met. Duet arrived at the party in the company of Princess Ada. I sense there's something going on between them. Oh, we're going to sleep with your girl? Yes, we are. It's going to happen. Right now.
You shall be summoned when I need you.
Whoa, I thought I was going to fall over for a second.
Get out of my sight, freak.
Not very nice.
That dwarven loan shark dared to demand repayment.
Varden, can I go to sleep somewhere, please? Because I'm going to be sick.
Geralt of Rivia and Triss Merigold, welcome.
Greetings.
I thank you for coming. Look about the room and you will see the entire kingdom represented.
We thank you for your invitation.
Forgive me, I must return to my duties. I'm certain we'll speak later.
You've met everyone who's anyone.
Correct.
I need to speak with Lavardin. You behave yourself. Beware of anyone who tries to pry information from you.
From me? But I'm just a witcher.
Don't be fooled. Anything you say may have political ramifications.
It may be worthwhile to talk to the other guy. Okay.
Now the Zerikan market is the future of commerce.
Excuse me, Geralt. I must speak with Lavardin.
They cannot expect us to fight at all. Rejoice in the profits and make them...
How many other guests? Come here, nobleman.
They cannot expect us to stand all night. They cannot expect us to stand
all
night. Why did they all come if they dislike Lavardin?
Uh-oh, there's Velarad. Not going to chat to him.
I have had enough of business and politics.
Welcome to Lord Lavardin's feast.
No way. I'm just going to... It's raining outside. Excuse me, it sounds beautiful. I like the rain. Oh my god, there's a bed. That's the wrong button. Stumbling around like a drunk. Come on, just lie on the bed for a second, Geralt. Give me a break. Ooh. A mysterious note. Written hastily in sloppy handwriting. Yes, please. Gold signet ring, be rude not to. Foreign lands. Tome describing a number of the world's regions, including the Nilfgaardian Empire, Zarakian, and Redanian. Oh, yes. Tell me about this mysterious note. The cast was done according to the guidelines, and the craftsmen are already gone for good. Make sure all the other traces vanish. Nobody should be able to prove that we are responsible for the forgery or find connection between me and your superior. You know what to do about the rest. P.S. Take care of the Witcher. Oh, it's like that. Okay, it's on. Wait, why did that say Thaler? Thaler is interested in the political situation of Vizima. He's also investigating an important case involving foreigners. Not foreigners, forgeries. Well, hey.
Why are you here?
Huh? I was looking for the privy.
In that box?
Mm-hmm.
Point for you. Truth is, I was hoping for a superior drink.
The wine does taste watered down.
I found some liquor. Try some?
Gladly.
Damn it. I don't really want to give you anything. I'm drunk.
A stupid idea.
It was a stupid idea. I've only just got my bloody feet back. I ain't getting drunk again. So who was that guy? Who was that masked man? Where's he go? Is it the counselor?
Vizima needs an aqueduct. I shall present plans to the council.
Mysterious nobleman.
Princess Ada should marry.
Thaler, look what I've got.
Enjoying yourself?
Exquisitely. Not enough food, nowhere to sit, and nothing but small talk. And I may be the only one here not involved in one of the many schemes or secret alliances being forged.
It's a sign of the times. New customs and fashions. You think it better to show the Nilfgaardian we're barbarians? That we can't distinguish between a fork and a comb? That the only way we know how to feast is to get blind drunk and roar lusty songs while slapping the serving wenches on their ass?
Yep.
I'm a relic, someone from the past, so I'm rather attached to the old customs. Never understood nor liked the new ones. But really, Thaler, why are you here?
I'm a patriot. I've the good of the kingdom at heart. A kingdom threatened by the schemes and alliances you were observant enough to note.
I said I was an old-fashioned witcher. Be straight, like Thaler the Fence would be.
Thaler the Fence does nothing for free.
Thaler the Fence is a scoundrel who'd prefer the Temple District not know he consorts with the cream of Vizima society.
Have it your way. Let me tell you, friend, a serious slash fest is in the works. One without pardon. The defeated will be picked apart by crows. You'll be forced to fight for a new order, comrade, or against it. We will fight for our traditions and customs, for our land and our women.
Who's this enemy? Who wants to steal our women?
I wouldn't deceive you. I think you're one of us. It's a cause we share. I don't know the enemy yet, but I will soon, and when I do, the time of the sword and the axe will come. Blood will flow in the streets. And know this, comrade, there will be no room for your neutrality.
Okay. Who is this, the wet guy? What's he doing here? Yeah, why do you want to drag me into this?
Why do you want to draw me into a game that doesn't concern me?
This game concerns you more than you imagine. You mean to tell me you're not interested in the conflict between the Order and the Scoia'tael? You mean to tell me you don't care? What about your lover, Triss Merigold?
That's private. I want to destroy Salamandra. That is my only objective.
Levardin just walked through a door.
Salamandra has a patron. Someone in this room, or one known here. You're up to your ears in this, Wolf, whether you like it or not.
Okay. Who the hell are you?
Who exactly are you? And be straight with me, comrade.
Temerian Intelligence. I execute the King's direct orders. I find traitors, rats, and foreign agents. I'm a spy.
A highly placed spy.
I can't deny it. May I ask a personal question? The amphibians you're after, are they a personal matter or an ideological one?
Bit from Pale A, bit from Pale B.
Both.
Care to explain?
They robbed me and killed a friend. They're criminal, evil. Salamandra upsets the balance. As a Witcher, I can't ignore that.
Got it. Thank you for being candid.
Who exactly is DeWitt, and what is he doing here?
That Nilfgaardian dog is a mere pawn. I cannot fathom why Ada tolerates him.
Explain.
Like most knights of the Order, he worries his dick's too small, so he gets aggressive whenever something scares him. Then, of course, he's a Nilfgaardian. Our princess has some weaknesses, but stupidity is not one of them.
Maybe the princess has a game of her own going.
Then she should choose better allies. Unlike chess, this game claims lives. I'm afraid someone might be using her.
We would definitely use her.
Is Luvarden somehow involved?
I'm going to check her out now. I'm not drunk.
I need to get Erkin a private meeting with him. At present, his intentions are a pure riddle.
To me, too.
Really?
What do you mean?
Your friend seems to get along famously with Luvarden. For two strangers, they certainly have much to discuss. See for yourself.
I trust Triss.
I suppose you know her better than I, but don't say I didn't warn you. Regarding Luvarden, we know he heads some transnational organization of merchants, bankers, and other wealthy folk. Make what you will of it.
Excuse me for a moment. We'll talk later.
Tala the Fence. Tala the Spy. Tala made me realize that my motivations are complex. DeWitt turned out to be sworn enemy of Tala, the chief of Temerian intelligence. Why put all the vapors in one nest?
The food will disappear soon.
We could go speak to... Where did our guy go? Varden? No. Can't you speak to Ed? Ada again.
Witcher, you may approach. DeWitt, fetch me some wine. From that page boy at the end of the room.
Your Highness.
We may speak freely now. Geralt, tell me about witchers, and please, don't hide behind your code.
What are you asking, m'lady?
What is your view on politics? To me, politics is like an encounter with a lover. Would you agree?
Oh, she's getting the heart. I'm impressed by the comparison. Have you ever tried your hand at the fine arts? Oh, yeah, here we go.
I'm impressed by the comparison. Have you ever tried your hand at the fine arts, Your Highness?
I'm forced to study all kinds of nonsense, but books bore me, as does poetry for the most part. Uh-uh.
I agree. Books are for bores.
Never mind. Back to our lovers ambulating about the room. You see, Witcher, politics is not unlike a tryst. It begins with foreplay, glances, conversations. Behold that witch with Luvarden. Now look to our noble Erkin in the courtiers. The dance grows bolder, fondling and such. Then, one is consumed by the desire to come together roughly, like animals.
She's gagging for it.
One is left with sad, passionless copulation. Velarad and DeWitt, for instance.
Oh,
excuse me, Your Highness. Sore throat.
We are adults, Geralt. We both know the desires of men.
I can see that. You might be right, Your Highness. Power, sex, power. Both come down to one thing. Fucking others. I don't want anything to do with politics, but...
You may be right, Your Highness. Power, sex, sex, power. They both come down to one thing. Fucking others. May I ask you a question?
Go on.
What is the King's stance on this topic? I mean politics, of course.
Ugh, dull. I have grown hungry, and there is naught worth eating at this feast. I tire of partridge tongues and caviar. What do I most desire? I have it. I will answer your ever so dull question.
If you
bring me what I most desire.
What do you desire? What do you want?
I shall return shortly, Your Highness.
Wait, I don't... Alright. No! Motherfucker!